Well, it's that time of year again. The weather's starting to cool off a little bit. The days are getting shorter. Fall color season is just right around the corner. So we're here about 5,500 feet above sea level right here on the Blue Ridge Parkway. That 5,500 number is really sort of a magic elevation when it comes to fall color, because that's that point on the landscape where, in the southern Appalachians at least, where your deciduous hardwoods give way to evergreens like Fraser Fir and red spruce at these higher elevations. So this is where fall color happens first. If you look around us today, there's not a whole lot of fall color happening just yet. 2019's been kind of an interesting year so far. If you go back to January and February, it started out really, really wet. And then as we got into the spring, it got really hot. Stayed hot all summer, got really dry towards the end of the summer. There's really two things going on right here with the plants. It's hot, and it's been hot for quite some time. That tends to tell the plants, okay, well, it's still the growing season. You might as well hold on to your leaves. But at the same time, it's dry, right? And that dry weather tends to cause plants to want to drop their leaves a little bit early. So if you look around a little bit, you do see some yellows. That's not really true fall color. You know what you're seeing on some of these birches and so forth. What you're looking at mostly there is just a little bit of drought stress. When trees go into the fall under a little bit of stress, what that tends to do is condense that fall color season and increases the likelihood that you have lots of different tree species firing off their best colors at the same time. So that's when you get that really diverse palette of colors, the yellows, the oranges, the reds, all happening at the same time. With this little bit of stress that they're going into fall with a nice gradual transition with that series of cold fronts, that's the formula for having a good fall color season. No freezing temperatures, no extreme winds. If we can get that from, say, mid-September on through mid-October, I think we can count on some really fantastic fall color at this elevation. Yeah, you just don't want those extreme events, like an early freeze. The thing about fall color, though, we have this really complex landscape. So you could get a freeze up here at 5,500 feet, but you might not get it down there at 4,500 feet. Right now, I don't see any true fall color development at this elevation. Even the yellow buckeyes, which are usually one of the first trees to drop their leaves, still nice and green. So we still have the entire fall color season ahead of us.